Hello, everybody, and thanks for calling in. We are doing a webinar today with Jimmy Lamb on weddings. I've got a couple ideas I share with my customers, and I think it's a topic that you'll take away from this session and actually implement and utilize. So let's get after it. Without further ado, once again, thank you. Probably get the opportunity to say thanks again at the end. I'm going to turn it on to Jimmy Lamb and let him do his thing. Thanks again, everybody.
Well, thanks, Don. And as Don said, we hopefully maybe you'll take something away from it. I usually try to cover a lot of different angles, and sometimes people are like, nope, that doesn't work for me. Nope, that doesn't either. Neither is that. But hopefully in all that, you're going to find something that will work out for you, you know, to help you with your business. Because definitely weddings have a lot of opportunities for sublimation, and therefore a lot of opportunities to make money. And that's really what it's all about at the end of the day. So without further ado, let's talk about weddings. So the wedding market. You know, if you think about weddings touch large groups of people who have a desire for unique and custom printed mementos and keepsakes of the wedding. Therefore, there's a lot of opportunity because there's a lot of people involved. And we know that most weddings are very picture centric. And those pictures end up on a whole lot of different things. There's more to it than just pictures, as you'll see as we go through here. There's a lot of different opportunities to cash in on the wedding market. But certainly, photos are an important part. When you think about sublimation, it's one of the best processes out there for reproducing photos. In fact, sublimation is so good if you have the right image, of course, and you're putting it onto the right surface with the right system. You can certainly do professional grade wedding portraits. In fact, we have wedding portrait photographers routinely use sublimation for wedding portraits. And when you think about that, that's a very high dollar item. And when you think of the cost of those particular portraits, there's a lot of money being sunk into it. So the quality must be good. And it is. Okay, we're able to do that. Profit potential for wedding products. Now, the U.S. has over 2.3 million weddings annually. 2.3 million, that's a lot, okay? And a lot of these are high expenditure events, okay? If you start looking at some of these numbers, it's almost kind of scary there. The average wedding budget is $20,000 in the U.S., with a total of $72 billion spent every year. Now, how would you like to have 10% of that? How would you like to have 1% of that? I mean, how would you like to have like 0.01% of that? Wishful thinking, right? But the point being, and I look at this with any market that I want to approach, is there is a market opportunity here. Trying to find statistics doesn't guarantee that you'll be successful, but it tells you a little bit about that market and just how big it is, okay? And when you look at something like just a wedding portrait alone costing anywhere from $2,000 to $10,000 and $40 to $50 per print off of that image, I mean, that's a huge amount of money people are spending. So keep this in mind. With a lot of these weddings, people are already conditioned to spend a large sum of money. So let's see if we can get some of that over into our checkbook, if you know what I mean. Okay, that's the kind of direction we want to go with this if we can do it. Well, if you look at a wedding, it splits into different segments. Okay, we think of a wedding as maybe just a wedding ceremony. But the idea is to be able to cash in from beginning to end. And it all begins with that ring and that proposal, okay? The engagement. And the engagement itself creates opportunity for sublimation and for you to make some money off of it as well. So let's think through those phases as we go through this. The phases look basically like this. Engagement and event planning, parties and gifts, wedding decor, and then honeymoon and post-wedding. So we can take each one of these and break it down and look for opportunities that might exist within that particular category. So let's start by talking about the engagement and event planning. The engagement typically includes a photograph, not of a wedding dress or anything like that, but either the bride-to-be or the couple. And those photographs end up in things like the newspaper and social media and things like that. But those same photographs can easily be put onto different products that can be positioned around any given household. In fact, that one photo could go onto multiple products because you know, the bride probably wants one, and maybe the groom wants one, and the bride's family and the groom's family and friends. And, you know, if you position it right, you can do a whole lot of different photo panels with that one image. Okay, so, you know, you want to take advantage of that, because once they move into another phase, they're not worried about the old phase anymore. So right off the bat, when you start thinking about your angles, if you start writing down your angles, and that's just kind of how I do a lot of things, is I look at my angle and then go and kind of write it all down where I want to go. This is definitely one of the angles, okay, the engagement memory per se. Then we have things that are engagement reminders, because now you start something in motion, moving from the engagement to the actual wedding ceremony. You find that things like refrigerator magnets are very nice, because not only are memento, but they actually can serve a purpose. Because for one of the things is those involved with the wedding have to deal with to-do lists, okay? Like bridesmaids and groomsmen, of course, you know, a lot of guys, we just lose all those lists. We don't follow directions well, but at least the bridesmaids, you know, they typically keep up with the list. And you may have different family members who are helping to plan that wedding who have different things going on. So these become nice things for the bride to give out to people, like the to-do list, for example, clipboards or refrigerator magnets that have reminders, or they're just used to hold reminders in place. And of course, you want to make that classy. And you can see a very good example here on the left is this pair of rings and then the date. Okay, we also refer to these as save the date. Okay, so these to-do lists are also known as save the date items. I apologize, my clipboard's a little bit blurry because it's blown up. But on the right, again, we have the rings, and then we see the bride's to-do list there, or the bridesmaid to-do list, or whatnot, depending on who it's going to. So you think about these things. If you're actually going to approach the wedding marketplace, maybe you can package certain things that start with the engagement. Okay, you build a package for the whole thing from beginning to end, and then you have your engagement aspect of that package, and of course you have these types of things in there. And then there's the bridal portrait, and chances are you're not going to do it, okay? Whoever the portrait photographer is probably going to take care of that. They're going to take the picture. They're going to go to the photo lab that's actually going to reproduce it, and they're probably going to take care of that. But those same images can be reprinted onto other things, okay? And Sublimation is worthy of pulling out the details and reproducing it at the highest level of definition. So that's an important aspect, okay? Can we tap into that bridal portrait and put it onto other things that maybe are given out to some other family members? Because the portrait tends to be fairly expensive. So if you can do a reprint on, say, a Chromalux metal panel, and metal panels just do a fantastic job with photography, then you can do a little bit lower cost ones that maybe an aunt and an uncle wish to have, or a friend wishes to have, or whatnot, so that it's not a $500 item. Okay, it's something that's a lot more affordable. So keep that in mind. Maybe we can tap into it, though you're probably not doing the actual portrait reproduction yourself. Okay, so that gives us some ideas for that starting point, okay, the engagement and planning. And then we start shifting over to some other things that happen along the way, some of the wedding products, still in the pre-wedding phase. But we start talking about parties and gifts. So you look at, first of all, maybe gifts from the groom. Remember, the groom gives gifts to the groomsmen. So, you know, guys typically prefer practical things, not necessarily sentimental. And we got all kinds of cool things that we can do for the guys, okay? I mean, anything from, you know, water bottles to shot glasses to just a lot of different things, okay? So this is where we start building these kind of packages as well. You say, okay, we can have this whole collection. You choose what you want out of here, and then you choose what kind of imaging you want on there, and these are the gifts that go to the groomsmen, okay? And they can be personalized any way that needs to be as well. And then we have gifts from the bride to the bridesmaids, and maybe even some people beyond that. You know, sometimes they use professional planners, but sometimes they use family members, and then maybe just that particular planner gets a gift or something. So it depends. I mean, they're giving gifts out. Typically, these are definitely more personalized and a little bit more sentimental. So you may be including pictures on this. You may be including monograms on this. And, you know, I'm a big favor of things that people use, because I just think it's important if you're going to give something to somebody, it's something that's useful to them instead of just a trinket that people don't get really excited about. So if you're putting these kind of things together, you could, you know, technically put together your own catalog. Now, I know that sounds kind of daunting, but all you need in a catalog is the ability to take some products and take some photos, and you could go into Microsoft Word and you can build the pages of your catalog. So we're not really talking about you're going out and hiring a professional print company, but you could have one page that has the gifts you want to offer from the bride, and then the next page is gifts from the groom. So, and then you have a page that's maybe your engagement photo products and the gifts and reminders and, you know, just all these different things, you know, the save the date, the to-do list items. You have a couple of different pages where people can thumb through and have some choice without being too crazy. Very easy to make these things, okay? You put a print them out on very good high-quality paper, probably put it in a three-ring binder so people can, you know, kind of thumb through it, and it looks professional and it works for you. You don't want to give them a big catalog. You know, Johnson's got a great catalog. No offense, Don, but you don't want to hand them the Johnson catalog probably because it'll be overwhelming to them, okay? They're planning a wedding. They don't understand sublimation, so if you can narrow it down to the key items that will be of interest and then just reprint those, that'll probably be what's going to work best. Okay, so let's move on from there and now start talking about wedding decor. You know, too many, a lot of times we think about the photos, we think about the gift items, those things, but there are certain things in the wedding itself and especially the reception afterwards where we can provide sublimated products to. Okay, so you want to keep that in mind. When you go into parties, for example, coasters. Coasters can be huge. Think about a reception at a $20,000 wedding. Think about a reception where maybe there's, you know, 50 or 60 people who are sitting down for dinner, or maybe it's light hors d'oeuvres or whatever, but they're going into reception and they're all sitting down. Well, that means that there's probably some kind of place setting where each person sits. They should all have a coaster that has maybe a picture of the bride and groom. So it becomes a nice gift, it becomes decoration, and it really captures the moment. And then you take it a little further, because you look at, like, where does the mother of the bride sit? Well, you give her her own special coaster, okay? And then there, you know, the mother of the groom has her own special coaster. And then maybe if there's a ring bearer, he has a coaster, has his picture on it, okay? Or whatnot. So you can have all these different personalized coasters. A lot of times people say, well, you can't make money with coasters. You certainly can make money with coasters, especially when you're putting the classy photos on there and you're selling them in bulk. You can definitely make some money on that. There's other cool things floating around out there. I mean, just basic, simple signage, okay? You have to think about it sometimes. Signage that says maybe you're going to put gifts here, or this is it's an announcement of the bride and groom and it's there by the cake or something. There's even directional signs that say, hey, the reception's this way. You know, there's a lot of different things that we can do here to enhance it. And part of all this is that brainstorming kind of thing. You know, taking a look at all the great sublimation products out there and then going and looking at everything people are doing in a wedding and then putting all these things into packages, okay? Packages where you show people, because a lot of times they're not thinking about these things and you want to hit them up with that. Okay, so you got to work to sell. Okay, yeah, here's some wedding signage, for example. You know, we can take a variety of different simple sublimation substrates and put things like, you know, mother of the groom, you know, and it's on her chair. Okay, whether it's inside in the church or outside in the sunshine, you can certainly, instead of having something that says reserved, you can have that actual signage, which is a nice keepsake for mom. Okay. You can see some of the other signage here where they're just pointing people to where they need to go. And they can be as simple as text or as sophisticated as having pictures with the text. And, you know, definitely if they have pictures, people are going to want to save that. The family's going to save it. It becomes worth that much more. You know, with sublimation, what defines the value of most of the products that we make is what we put on them. And if you're putting pictures on there that touch people's hearts and get them emotionally charged, they see a higher value in it. So you want to encourage putting pictures on things because you want to use the angle of, this is not a throwaway piece, this is a keepsake from the wedding, okay? So think about that. Even with your wedding signage, are we able to put photographs onto it and really decorate it up nice? I mean, you know, it doesn't change the cost of the sublimation, but it changes the perceived value, and therefore it gives us a higher margin. So that's the kind of thing we want to think through. Then we have a variety of wedding products that really come out of what we call post-wedding. And post-wedding, I mean, let's face it, a lot of the photographs that get taken aren't even available until after the wedding, okay? You can only use photographs for products used in the wedding or pre-wedding that were taken, of course, before the wedding. So some of the poses and things like you see here, they probably don't occur or are not available until after the wedding. You're certainly not going to be able to sublimate anything during the wedding. Well, I guess you could if you're really creative, but whatever. The point being is there's a whole lot of things that happen after the wedding, so you want to look at having all these different types of souvenir, we'll call it souvenir products. I think keepsake, mementos is a much better when we're talking about a wedding. But different things like luggage tags and things like that. And, you know, in fact, for that matter, if you're talking about luggage tags, you can make that where it maybe doesn't have their picture, but it's luggage tags, you know, one for him, one for her, you know, that's going to be used on the honeymoon and things like that. You can do the bride and groom cups where it doesn't have a picture, but that can be, certainly be used within the actual ceremonies themselves. But then afterwards, anything that you want to put pictures on, those are the items that will have to be wait until after the pictures have been developed and processed before you can get your hands on them and do anything with them. But there's a lot of different things there that you can put the images on. A lot of different things. And the creativity is really up to you. But the idea is that you don't sell these afterwards. You put it into packages again where they're picking the products they want, and then they're able to choose the photographs, you know, that they want on those products, and then you create the products for them. So that's the whole concept, you know, kind of from beginning to end, how many different things can we tap into along the way? Okay, marketing wedding products. Probably your best approach, I mean, really, you trying to do it yourself gets tricky because that means you got to track down all the brides, okay? And they're busy with a lot of different things going on. A lot of brides, not all of them, but a whole lot of them use a wedding planner. So the logical starting point is to go find wedding planners. Because if you go and work with a wedding planner, wedding planner is making money off everything they sell. So if you're able to put together packages that make sense, that are easy for the wedding planner to sell, okay, that's important that the wedding planner needs to find it easy to be able to market and sell the particular things that you want to offer because they're not sublimators. So keep that in mind, that that's a good starting point, okay? So you want to package things around what they can sell. And definitely a lot of them don't have any idea what you can do. So if you actually start building packages and then you go meet with wedding planners, they can kind of help you fine-tune your package to say this makes sense and maybe that doesn't make sense, okay? So I would certainly track down professional wedding planners and then start pitching the ideas to them. And don't just go sit down and say, oh, I have an idea. I mean, the idea is that you go ahead and build some packages and lay them out where you can walk in and show them, okay? And, you know, when I build kits, sales kits, I like it to be with a central theme, okay? So in other words, if you're able to go and take maybe a real wedding, some, you know, family and friends or something, or a fictitious wedding, and you can get images online from a couple of different image companies so that you could look like you built this entire sample pack for one wedding event from beginning to end, then it has that nice common theme of the same people all the way through, okay? So I think that's one of the best ways to put together. I don't like a mishmash of different products with a whole bunch of unrelated images. I think that's confusing and unprofessional to look at. The idea is to show somebody all these products that were used for this one wedding. So take some time to build it that way is what I'm trying to tell you, and then they can help you fine-tune it and go from there. In addition to wedding planners, talk to photographers. Now, you may not get everything that you're currently could do, but photographers, I mean, so many of them make, you know, a living off of wedding pictures. So for them, being able to sell more things with those images is better for them. So you're going to be doing the work. I mean, right now, they'll send stuff out usually to a photo lab to be processed, but why don't you become the photo lab, at least for the things that make sense for you to do? So I would definitely talk to professional photographers, show them some really cool product lines that they can put together into packaging to be able to, you know, present to their target client. And florists, believe it or not. I mean, a lot of times people with florists are like, well, they just do flowers. They're not interested in sublimation. Let me tell you something. I've got a friend who's a florist, and she can do just about anything you need for a wedding. Okay, I'm not all florists are going to be at that level, but I mean, the woman just does everything. She does wedding invitations. She can arrange a photographer. She does candles. She does flowers. She does everything you can imagine, but she is a florist. So, you know, this is one of those things, too, where florists are always looking, you know, anybody that's servicing the wedding is always looking, how can I make more money off this wedding? And you might be the ticket for other people to make more money off the wedding. And again, these people are already in the business of dealing with weddings, which means they already have people coming to them. So you don't have to go seek out the wedding customer. These people are already finding them and dealing with them. Oh, yeah, they got to make money on it too, which means your margin won't be as large because you've got to have affordable pricing that they can resell and make money. But the reality is they're doing all the legwork, so why not? So kind of work through that and think it through as you go. Even gift and stationery stores. You know, these stores, you know, a lot of them offer cards, but they offer other types of gift items too. And this might be a place where you could pick up some wedding business as well. Remember, not all weddings are high-dollar events, and not all weddings are done with wedding planners. And sometimes it's the bride or the bride and groom or the bride and her mother are going and really doing all the detailing themselves. So this is where maybe you capture them as they're knocking on the doors of each of their different subcontractors. Okay, same thing with the florist or the photographer. So keep that in mind that this is just another angle to pick up some of the business. Okay, so that kind of covers what I wanted to with weddings. The idea, again, is to put together concepts, okay? I mean, let me tell you something. From having done decorated products for many, many years, the most successful people are the ones who are very, I don't want to use the word aggressive, but I will. And that means, you know, scoping out your marketplace and coming up with a plan and putting together sample products and learning and educating yourself and talking to people and refining and things like that, okay? This is not about saying, hi, I'm Jimmy, I do sublimation. Would you like me to do some gifts for your wedding? You know, that's not going to get you business. You really need to think it through, put it together, but there's a lot of business to be had with wedding products, so you want to keep that in mind. And definitely you're going to need some sampling to do it right, you know, and you know, if you haven't looked lately, I mean, the Johnson Plastics catalog has so many unique products that just fit so well for the wedding marketplace. That's a good starting point to say, what the heck am I going to put together in my kit, you know, my sample kit? So with that said, cheers. And I'm going to give you our email addresses here if you want to follow up with us afterwards with different questions. Plus, I'll take any questions you have now. And Don, I think you're back with us too.
I am. I've got a few things to add, Jimmy, on some
go products right
that my customers have been printing on for years, and I've adopted these and shared them with my customers, my new customers, at a wedding, a tent card. Now, a tent card made out of metal, folded over the picture of the bride and groom on one side, each side, and table number one, table number two, and so forth. And somebody gets to take that home at the end of the evening. With the new Chromalux panels, depending on the size of that album cover, or the album, the photo album, they can use that Chromalux, drill a few holes in the side with the wedding photograph, and have your album cover made out of Chromalux, the aluminum. It's 045, nice and rigid. And then yep. The last one I really like, it's the Subla decal material, sublimated onto the wedding party, and then maybe adhered to a wine bottle.
Cool idea.
You got about 10 to 12 people in that wedding party. Each one gets a bottle of wine with the wedding party on it. That's pretty, I like that a lot. That is
really a cool idea.
Yeah. But those are three nice ones that I have that are fairly inexpensive to implement.
Yep.
I do want to thank everybody for coming today.
Yeah, I got a couple of questions here.
Mm-hmm.
Number one, I assume you must have permission from the photographer. Well, you know, when you talk about a professional photographer taking photos, they do have the copyright on the photo because they took it and it was taken using their abilities, okay? So it's considered intellectual property, and therefore they have the copyright. And it really kind of comes down to the permissions that are given there. Typically, they don't lent copies of the images out of their hands without someone paying for those copies, okay? So when someone engages a photographer, they do sign some type of agreement that says, this is how many reprints you can do, and this, that, and it tells you what you can and can't do. So yeah, there is a copyright issue there, but the fact of the matter is they're typically not going to give you any of the prints just unless there's some fee already been paid, and then that fee will usually secure whatever copyright issue is required. What was the material again for the decals, Don?
We have a sublet decal material. It's in the catalog, sublet decal, pretty inexpensive. 10 sheets for 8.5 by 11 sheets at $10.90 in that neighborhood. So,
okay.
Once again, pretty inexpensive.
Now, do you know if those are stocked at the Arizona warehouse that just came in?
I think they're stocked all over. That's how popular they are. But I'll give it a search real quick.
Okay. In the meantime, someone says we actually were thinking about using poker chips as memory wedding tokens, but are
nice.
Having trouble with the proper heat settings and time. So that's one where I'd give a call to, you know, tech support at Johnson Plastics and let them walk you through and see if you can figure out what's going on with that.
Great idea. Arizona has 164. Sheets of that stuff.
There we go. So we answered that one.
8.5 by 11, yeah. Looks like every warehouse has them.
Someone's looking for a low-cost frame where the couple's photo can be inserted, but with the decoration in the background and insert. Can you send? Anyway, they're looking for a frame, it looks like, where you can slide photographs into rather than sublimating the photograph. Into it. They're looking for something that's a little cheaper in price than some of the current Unisub products.
I don't know of any right now, Jimmy. I don't typically use the word cheaper anyways, when it comes to weddings. But there is a Unisub product in here that's high-end.
Right.
It's got a slot on one side for the bride and groom, and then an area on the other side for the wedding party, which is a great momentum to have the wedding party on one side and the bride and groom on the other.
Yep. Are the sublet decals like bottle wraps? They're just really you describe them.
Yeah, you basically sublimate it, and it's got a pressure. It's pressure sensitive on the backside. You peel that off and carefully line it up on your product, and voila, you've got it.
Cool.
A decal material that's pressure sensitive on one side. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I know. There's several different product questions, and that's one of the ones I'd suggest that if you're looking for something unique, because there are some people seeing questions of looking for things that sound fairly unique. I would visit the Johnson Plastics website first, and if you can't find it, contact Johnson Plastics and tell them what you're looking for, because they may be able to steer you into something similar or come up with a substitute idea if you can't find exactly what you want, right off the bat. And because you guys got a lot of stuff. You know what my favorite thing is that you have, and that's fishing lures. I mean, that could be a gift for the groomsmen, okay? Hey.
Absolutely. Yes, or, indeed, if they're...
Yeah, well, I was hooked.
A buddy of mine took his wedding party on a charter fishing trip.
Oh, really? I wish I could have been at his wedding party. I don't even have to know the guy. Anyway. Okay. So, anyway.
Imagination. Yeah.
I know. And that's the whole thing. With everything we do, I mean, there's lots of neat marketplaces out there. One of the things I would suggest, too, maybe for some ideas, is go to some of the wedding shows. I mean, there's a lot of wedding shows going on right now. And go to those shows, walk through them, look and listen, see what's going on. and you can probably meet some wedding planners there too. But that's a good place to get some good information and ideas, and then come back and start putting together your ideas. So I think that pretty much covers it today, Don. Appreciate the opportunity to come out and chat a little bit. And with that said, I'm going to go ahead and wind things down. So, Don, thanks for having me out, and I look forward to
working with you. Thank you so much, Jimmy. As always, an excellent job to my customers and potential customers. By all means, should anybody have any questions or concerns, get up with me at donf@johnsonplastics.com. And once again, thanks so much.